Hello and welcome to Lancaster Tonight with me, your host, Siri Hampapore. So it's episode 4 and we're definitely having some fun with this show. Last week we were chatting to Jonathan Parks and we talked all about his music, who he is as an artist, and I think we can safely say that we really got to know who he was. And I think he left with at least some of his dignity intact, but at least we got a good interview out of it. So today we'll be talking about Michael Mander, Associate Editor of Scan, all about how he got into journalism. And first of all, we just got a quick reminder about Lancaster's Got Talent, which is this Saturday. It's the final, so make sure you come along. Tickets are still available on the Lancaster University Students' Union website. And if you're not quite convinced, let's take a look at the promo video that Craig made. And after this, we'll be joined by Michael, so stay tuned. So here you are, Michael Mander, Associate Editor of Scan.
All right.
Thanks for coming on the show.
Anytime, always happy to be here.
Yeah, no worries. So let's chat about like how we met.
Okay.
Because like we've been friends for a while now.
Yeah,
so,
well,
yeah.
Have we?
I mean, actually, I don't know. Because I feel like I've known you for longer than I've been friends with you.
The only vivid memory I have of our friendship prior to this academic year is Last Roses when we spoke. And we definitely spoke Last Roses.
Did we? What did we speak about? Because I don't remember.
I don't
this.
Know. You were cheerleading. Or were you?
No, I wasn't, because I was just coaching.
Well, then, even that's not a good memory. You were doing something.
Yeah, because I knew of you before I was, like, talking to you. So, like, we applied. You knew of me. Because we applied for a job.
GML a few times.
Yeah, you have. We applied for this trip.
Okay, I know what you're talking about.
Yeah, we applied to go to India on a trip. It was like a media thing.
Yeah.
So, you
know, Lucy Media.
It was me and Jack Hill who really wanted to go. And they sent Jack Hill and
Michael Mander.
And Michael Mander instead. So that was quite interesting. So I kind of knew of you as the person who
and
took my spot.
Me.
I did resent you.
Which is generally how most
of
my friendships
while,
begin,
actually.
I would say.
I resented
with
you for quite a while.
Me.
And then I realised, oh, actually, like, you know, he's quite good at what he does. Like, he's in Scan.
Nice boy, lovely boy.
I mean, would I go that far? So I thought, we'll get him on GML because you were news editor last year.
And you introduced me as editor. Or not you, someone
did.
Someone did.
I don't think I would have done
been?
That.
Who was the boy? Who did GML last year?
Ben Wallace. Was it Ben Wallace?
Could have been
Ben.
And he introduced me as editor. I was like, okay.
Fair enough. But now you're associate editor.
Associate editor, yeah.
Michael Mander, associate editor of Scan.
Correct.
And that's your like.
And been on GML as associate editor of Scan.
Yes, you have.
In week one.
This year.
What a thrill.
You've got like a little meme, don't you? A little Michael Mander meme.
Brilliant. No, I would not go that far.
I would go that far because.
I would say you have a meme to a certain extent.
I would. What's my meme?
Because. Well, Siri.
What?
One time. I don't know if you remember, but we all got legal trained for to have our roles in respective student meetings. We all got legal trained.
I remember this.
And one of my friends went along from Scan.
Oh, no.
Representing Scan at legal training, and he was eager to learn the ins and outs of media law, of course. Stan.
If
Stan's watching.
Stan from Scan.
And
I know where this is going.
Stan walks in the room, excited to meet some new people. Get to know the media scene, and what happened, Siri?
Well, okay, so basically, I was at LA1. We have, like, quite a high energy, so I just came in.
And we have quite, I would say, low energy.
Scan's a bit different. Scan's got a very different vibe to, like, what we do at LA1.
Yeah.
So me, Patrick and Ellie, we were just, like, in the room, and we were just sort of, like, dancing. So what was Stan's reaction?
I think Stan was just bewildered.
Who's, what did he say to you though?
He said, I walked in and they were just dancing. And I was like, well, that's
he
weird.
He was just so confused. And what, no, he said we left
and
him
then,
out.
And then, well, yeah, and this is the next part. You all, so you're all dancing.
Yeah, we're all dancing.
He's still standing there. I don't know, I would love to have been in the room. What was he doing when you were dancing?
We were just dancing in our own little worlds. I don't think we'd paid
okay,
any attention.
Okay, well, he was standing there, like, shocked, I imagine.
Yeah.
And then you all sat, so there's tables of what? Rows of what, five?
Yeah,
something. And how many
like
of you
that.
Were there? Four?
Three.
Oh, well, then it was rows of four, and there were three of you. Rather than sit on the end of the row, so Stan could have sat next to you, he sat on the wrong end of the row, so Stan couldn't get in and sit next to you, so he had to sit on his own behind you.
Oh, I felt
And then
so
along came Balrog, and do they sit next to Stan? They don't, they sit on the row behind him. And so ever since then, I've just... I mean, it kind of made me realise where we stood with the student media.
It was a bad day
Stan,
for Stan
as a representative
and
Scan. Was shunned.
I feel really bad about that, so I'm going to do like a public apology to Stan from Scan. I'm really sorry. I didn't mean to leave you out of like the group, and I'm really sorry that you were kind of confused by our dancing as well. It's purely like an LA1 thing. Mm. We did it at a social the other day as well. It's like a long story, but like we'll chat about that later, Stan.
Did you have a good social?
We did. We had a great social. It was a board game.
Because you were at our most recent Scan social as well.
Oh, yes, I was. That was so much fun. Yeah.
Well, there you go. There's the difference in reactions. How LA1 social was.
Yeah, it was like... No, it was good. I mean, it was all about, like, getting to know new people.
What's so, the LA1 one?
Yeah, the LA1. And I met some new people at Scan as well.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, that I didn't know.
Yeah, well, lovely... bunch
yeah
at Scan.
Lovely bunch.
Lovely bunch of LA1, I'm sure.
They are. You should come on one of our socials next time.
what
was this space for?
No, I will.
Yeah. Okay, next time. Next time you better come along. But anyway, how did you get into journalism? We're just going to go straight into
okay.
it. Because, like, you're really good at what you do, and I feel like,
thanks.
You know.
Well, I always liked writing. I don't suppose I've ever actually told you this.
I mean, like, you've told me this, and I feel like most of the time when I chat to people on my show, I go like, oh, how did you do this? Or like, when did you start doing this? And most likely I know this information already, but this is for the viewers at home that don't know you, Michael.
Okay, well, I always liked writing.
Yeah.
And then there was a little local magazine, like in Billericay, where I'm from, Billericay, Essex.
Shout out.
Represent. There's a little magazine for just, and Billericay is a small place, so it wasn't a big magazine or anything. And they were looking for young people to write comments. And I was like comment pieces. And I was like 15, maybe 14. And
comment pieces are opinions.
Opinions.
Yeah.
So yeah, I was like, yeah, I've got some opinions. I'll write my opinions. Mm-hmm. So I wrote some opinions. Then went up in the world, did some work experience at the Brentwood and Billericay Gazette.
Oh.
So I'm adding a town to my... You know,
yeah.
What's the word?
Readership.
My readership.
There you go.
And I was like, I'd like to write opinions because I thought I wanted to write opinions.
Yeah.
And then I got there and they were like, do you mind writing some news? So I wrote a bit of news and I was like, well, I've been writing opinions all this time. I like writing news. So I did that for 2 weeks, not very long. Then kind of did a few odd jobs for like £5 and £10.
Cool.
All over the shop, writing this and that about news. Got to uni. And at this point I'm like, yeah, I think I want to be a journalist.
Mm.
I did a non-journalism subject because I wasn't 100%, but I was like...
What do you study?
Linguistics. So I was like, maybe if I don't want to go into journalism, at least I've got linguistics.
Mm-hmm.
So I joined Scan,
there
Lancaster
you go.
University student newspaper.
Yeah.
Wrote my first article on a loyalty card that came to campus.
Oh, okay.
And that no one's ever used, I don't think. Wrote my second article about professor getting arrested, and I won't go through all of them, but there were many
yeah,
more
that's
to come.
Cool.
Came news editor, came associate editor, started from the bottom.
And now you're here.
Now I am here.
To quote Drake,
yeah.
The finest. So what was it about news that sort of like attracted you more to that than comment pieces?
I think I just realised I didn't have any opinions that anyone cared about.
I'm sure that's not true.
In the most, well... Who wants to hear what a boy from Billericay thinks of the world? Like, there's plenty of... Everyone's got an opinion on something. And, like, most people don't give anything about your opinion. I don't know what to.
I mean, yeah.
But yeah. And so when I realised that, I thought, well, what do people give an anything about? And they give about news. Everyone cares about news. And I like writing news. I just enjoy it.
Yeah, I think it's interesting. I mean, like, I think I was kind of attracted to, like, the news side of the production, TV production.
Yeah.
Good Morning Lancaster. So saw some collaboration
you
between
the content, didn't you?
Scan and LA1.
You prefer the content to the production.
Definitely.
Yeah.
It's interesting. What's been your proudest article then so far?
Good question. Obviously the one we did this term about the union suing.
Yeah.
The union threatening to sue the council. I was very proud of that one because there was this document that I really wanted and I got it. And then I wanted to use the word threaten and I wanted to use the word sue, but they were such big words. I was like, should I use them? And then we used them. And so I was very proud of that one. Did an interesting one about gowns and gown hire. Very proud of that in the Telegraph. Not for Scan. there was a good one last year as well, but I've forgotten what it was now. But I'll get back to you on that if I remember.
Oh, but that's cool. You've made it into the Telegraph.
Yeah, once.
How did that occur?
One little column. Well, I wrote an article. Ah, the other one, I remembered it. It was about essay mills and about people buying essays online.
Yeah.
So I wrote that. And then I realised, I've got like, not many Twitter followers, but a few of them are journalists. And one of them was the online education editor for The Telegraph. I can't remember his name. I feel like it's Harry York. Harry York, online editor of The Telegraph. And so I dropped him a DM like, I wrote this article and it was based on one of your articles. I was wondering if you'd be interested in reading it. And he was like, yeah, really good. Thanks for sending me that. It's really good. We would even consider publishing it if you put a national spin on it. And I was like, interesting.
That's sick.
And then the next time a story came up that I thought I can put a national spin on this, dropped him another cheeky DM, which is what I do, slide in. And I was like, working on this story, reckon it could have a national angle.
Yeah.
Do you fancy it, Harry? And he was like, yeah, I'll have that.
Sick.
Yeah, he did.
Yeah. So like,
so that was, I was very proud of that one, obviously.
It's really good that you took that initiative as well.
Yeah, well, I'm a big DM slider.
Yeah.
I'm a big fan of it.
Yeah, I think like investigative journalism, that's kind of what it's about, like just being curious and like asking those questions.
I think so too, and it's a lot of like, I always found when stuff was going on, I'd be like, well, I want to know what's going on there. And all the things that you would do as an investigative journalist, I kind of just did out of curiosity.
Yeah.
And then I thought, I'm getting all this information, what should I be doing with it? Turn it into an article.
So,
there we go.
So is that where like most of the inspiration of like, these articles come from?
Yeah, I just think like either something's not right or what's going on here. I like my own curiosity, I think. And if I wasn't doing it for a paper, I'd be doing it for myself because like it would frustrate me not to know.
That's true. What do you think makes good news then? Because like this differs like from person to person. Because like some people think yes, that's newsworthy, and then some people are just like why?
I don't know. I think it's hard to toe the line because I know. I always think like there's this dilemma about, I know what's good news and then I know what's going to get reads and they're not always the same thing.
Oh, that's so interesting.
But then I guess the stuff that's getting reads must be good news because people's reading it. So I can say we're doing an article in this next coming up edition about the flood.
Mm-hmm. I mean, that's literally what we've done.
Yeah,
we did
it's a really
report
good article,
it.
And they've done a really good job, the writer on it. But it's in terms of like the digging into a story and getting the different angles and sort of uncovering things about like seeking truth and stuff like that.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a story about a flood.
Yeah, exactly.
but it's a really good article, and it's going to get loads of views because people care about the floods.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because that's kind of what we thought as well. When the floods happened, we didn't think anything of it as a station, to be honest. We just thought, it's Lancaster, it floods, it happens. And then all of a sudden, ITN was coming along, all these major broadcasters were coming along just to get like footage of these floods.
Yeah.
And we were just like, well, if they're going to get on it, we're going to get on it.
Yeah.
So that's what we did.
Well, it's just like the thing, like this week, was it this week? Prince Harry got engaged.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's like, it's not good journalism, is it, to report on Prince Harry getting engaged?
Yeah, that was
like
breaking news on the
royal
BBC
expenses
app.
Or like investigate something like that. But it's just going to get reads knowing that
true.
A prince is engaged. And so I guess that's good news, but it's not good. It's not like quality news, I don't suppose.
No, but I mean, I guess if people are interested, then...
Well, exactly, and I suppose that's what I'm saying. Like, the stuff that's sometimes the most important is also the most boring.
Yeah.
And the stuff that's the least important and the waffle is the most interesting.
Yeah, and speaking of these floods...
speaking of waffle, sorry.
Myself and Craig did a report for LA1 TV News, and as we said before, it was in association with ITN, so let's just take a look at how bad it was. We're here at Lancaster University after a night of heavy rain and flash flooding, and you would not recognise campus today if you'd seen it last night.
We've got more rain on the way and we've got high winds at the moment, so the authorities are trying to clear the water as best they can, but there's still lots of localised flooding.
Yeah, they seem to have done a good job, but we're still in Pendle College, and as you can see, there is still a massive lake. We can't tell how deep the water is, which is one of the dangers of flash flooding. For many students last night who were having some fun with the rain.
Absolutely. We had people in the underpass, which is the main bus stop for campus. Although it was completely closed, there were still some people having a swim and some water skiing.
We do advise that students stay safe during this kind of weather and not put yourselves in any danger or risk, as these floods can be quite dangerous.
The president of the Students' Union, Josh Wolfe, gave a message on the Overheard at Lancaster Facebook page telling people to stay safe and wrap up warm, although campus was still open.
This has been Siri Hampapore
and Craig Underwood
reporting for LA1 TV News. So yeah, that was our little VT. What were you going to say?
I think that's one of the best I've seen from
LA1. Oh, thank you. Really, we did stuff. Put a lot of effort into that. Like, ITN wanted this footage, and so I got this email from the student union saying, ITN wants this footage, how quickly can you get down to Lancaster to film this? And I was like, okay. So I ran to the office, grabbed a camera, rang up Craig, telling him to get to the office ASAP. A second later, he was knocking on the door because he was already there.
Classic Craig,
always on the ball. And then I was messaging Joel as well, get to the office ASAP, ITN wants footage. Like, this could be like national. And then we were literally driving all around Lancaster to get this. So we drove down to Galgate, where all like the fire engines were. Then back into town to see if there was anything still flooded there. Apparently the Yorkshire House pub was completely flooded. We didn't actually get in to see it, but we were sent pictures from people who were there. Someone's kitchen was completely flooded as well. But yeah, it was great. It was a lot of fun. We felt like true reporters.
True reporters, yeah, well that's good. And
Yeah, so let's get on with the challenge that I've got prepared for you today, Michael.
I'm ready.
So, okay, we're going to play the two truths, one lie challenge.
Okay,
so I feel like as a journalist, you have to be good at lying. And you've told me that you're a good liar as well.
Yeah.
Okay, so you're going
to... Oh, my God, I'm doing it.
Yeah.
Wow,
yeah.
Okay. Well, yeah. I need to tell me
two truths and a lie. And then I have to guess what you're lying about.
Okay.
So, yeah. I mean, I thought you got that from...
I thought you were going to give me two truths and a lie.
No. No.
Okay.
That's you. Okay, I'm going to give you a second. Just have a think.
Okay, yeah, let me have a think. Because I'm trying to think. I can come up with some cool ones, but there's a chance my parents will watch it. Will watch
That's
this.
Fine. Or have you told them about employer. This?
Well, now I've even said that, and I can't, now I've even raised my suspicions there. Okay, let me think. Okay, I've been robbed in Spain, I've been at gunpoint in Morocco, and I've been punched in Budapest.
Oh, God. You feel it?
And you can ask me questions about them if you want.
Okay, that's cool. Can I dig into each of the stories?
It. Okay. I'm confident in all of them.
Okay, so I have to go for the... At gunpoint in Morocco. What was that situation? Tell me about that.
I was with the fam. We accidentally bowled into a Moroccan palace or something like that, and all the guards were like...
I know that's true.
Oh, have I told you that story?
Yeah, you told me this story.
Oh, okay, well then there's one.
Okay. What was the other two again?
Robbed in Spain. And punched in Budapest.
Okay, tell me about...
Budapest is the only one that's not a country. Budapest is a city, isn't it?
Okay.
Maybe, is that a hint?
I mean, Why would that be a hint? I've just asked for two truths and a lie. Okay, I've not asked about
what
countries.
Was your question?
I don't know. I was just going to ask more about this Budapest story.
Okay. I was in Budapest.
Yeah.
Sat in a park.
Yeah.
I thought I was reading a book, but I think I was getting my book out.
This is a lie.
And then a man walks up to me, started shouting in Hungarian, and I was like, what? What are you saying?
No.
And then he punched me.
No.
And then he walked away.
This is a lie.
And then the Budapest police came over and started talking to me in Hungarian, and I was just like, I don't know what's going on. And then that was the end of, like, he exited my life and I exited his.
Okay. Okay, my answer is that was a lie.
No, that was true.
What?
I haven't been robbed in Spain. I've never been robbed.
Oh, my God.
The Budapest thing is true. It's the weirdest morning of my life. He just came over. He was angry about something. I don't know if he got me confused for someone. Or maybe I did something drunk the night before that I forgot.
That was probably, yeah. That's probably it.
I don't think so, though. I didn't recognise him. Hmm. 1 minute, I was fine. The next time, I was getting a punch around the face.
Fair
there
enough.
You go.
I mean, that's a really cool story.
I feel like
I'm glad
you.
That's true. I mean, I'm a bit shook, but
yeah.
I'm glad that's the truth because, like, it's a really cool story.
Thanks. Well, it wasn't cool at the time.
I mean, yeah, obviously not, but now you could, I mean...
But it wasn't even,
no,
like...
No damage is done.
It wasn't scary or horrible or anything. It was just confusing.
Yeah.
I mean,
I'd be a bit confused if someone did that to me. I'd be like...
And Hungarian isn't a pretty language.
Yeah, no, I wouldn't imagine. Do another one.
Oh, it took me ages to come up with that one.
Yeah, that was a good one, though. But, like, we need something else on that level.
Something else on that level.
Because I feel like you've got good stories, so you could say... You could literally do anything.
Okay.
I'm excited.
This is hard.
Come on, you can do
this. It's so hard. Have you thought of one?
Not thought of one.
Maybe you should think of one.
What? I'm really bad at lying, though.
It's hard to think of the lie. That's the problem. I can think of two truths.
I'll
get back to you with that one.
Yeah, we're just not going to do that challenge anymore. I think it's a difficult challenge, but I enjoyed the ones that you did say.
Well, you're very welcome.
Yeah, okay. I think we're going to go to the Pictionary challenge now.
Okay.
So, basically, on my show, I get all my guests to draw me. So, and I've warned you about this. I have told you.
I thought it was a joke.
No, I've told you in advance that all my guests have to draw me. So, here we go. Here's your paper.
All right, well, I'm going to keep it simple.
Here are your pens. So, I was going to give you a minute, but I think everyone else has gotten 30 seconds, so I can only give you 30 seconds.
Well, and it's a shorter show, so maybe I should have 15.
What, 15 seconds? No.
Because it's a half the length of a normal one, isn't it?
Okay, do you know what? No, what are you doing?
If I'm only getting 15 seconds, I'm going to make a start.
I need to count you down, Michael. What
okay,
are you doing?
Okay, go. Ready?
Okay.
I don't want to do this, Siri.
2, 1, go. You can do this. Remember, you can do this. Like, I'm sat right here, so you have no excuse. Okay. I'm looking forward to seeing this. 3, 2,
I didn't get time to
one.
Do the face. Was that seriously
Stop.
15 seconds?
Yeah, that was 15 seconds. Stop! You had more than 15 seconds.
All right, well, we're going to go ahead and keep this one for ourselves.
Okay, you need to sign it now and show it to the camera once you're done.
Which one?
That one.
There you go.
To be fair,
I got the boots.
You got the boots.
The hair.
And the hair.
A bit longer.
And you gave me a massive smile, which is cute.
And you have got a big smile.
And
no nose. Like,
no nose.
Or ears.
I just feel like this is probably the most like visually pleasing drawing I've had of me.
Yeah.
Because like most of the time, like they either don't give me hair or give me a massive nose.
So I didn't even give you a
you
nose.
You didn't even give me a nose, and you've given me really long hair, which is nice. And you've made me really skinny, and my boots, and it's just...
Yeah, you're very welcome.
It's a stick.
You're very welcome.
But it's great. Okay, I mean, I actually like this, and it's probably my favourite.
Well, keep
of
it.
All men. I will. I mean, I am. But yeah. So, I mean, I think that's all we've got time for today, but thanks for coming on the show.
You're very welcome. Apologies because I was a bit late.
No worries.
It was always a pleasure to be here.
Yeah, I mean, come on again.
Maybe I'll start my own show.
Maybe you will.
Lancaster this afternoon
with Michael Mander, associate editor of Scan.
Associate editor of Scan. Yeah, it wouldn't fit on the screen.
No, won't be my show though. But anyway, thanks for coming on, and thank you to all the crew as well for another amazing episode, and we'll see you next week.